the globe, in all the continents, among all races, on all people and communities, Jesus is celebrated. A baby who was born in a very poor family, in a very poor condition, in an unknown place called Bethlehem, has conquered the hearts of millions and billions of people across generations, past 2,000 years, and even for the next centuries, until the return of the Lord Jesus Christ, He will still live in millions and billions of people's heart. What a great child was born among us. In the light of the scriptures, we are going to have a short meditation, just for 5 minutes. The angels declared to the shepherds, the most common people, the poor people of those days, the shepherd, "Don't be afraid, I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people." It is a good news that has really brought great joy to all the people, to all mankind. There is a reason behind this statement by the angels. They explain it out like this. The Savior, yes, the Savior, the Messiah, the Lord Himself has been born today in Bethlehem. The Lord Himself, the pre-existing God, is born among men. The one who's everlasting is born among men. He chose a virgin, young Jewish girl, to be the vessel for His birth. What an amazing, amazing story, that God will humble Himself from His throne and be born in a poor condition, in a manger, in a manger. What is so special about this baby that we are celebrating? He is the Savior of mankind. He came on a rescue mission. He came to rescue you and me. He is the Messiah whom the Israelites were waiting for generations, for centuries. They were waiting for someone who will come and deliver them. And that Messiah was born in Bethlehem. He is the King of the Jews, the Jewish people. He was the King born in a manger. He was the one who the prophets foretold hundreds of years back, and they waited and they cried for the day of Christmas. Prophets were earnestly crying for the day when the Messiah will come. They call Him as a wonderful counselor. He's going to be a wonderful counselor. He's a mighty God. He's an everlasting Father. And He's the Prince of Peace. That's how the prophets saw Him. The shepherds, the common men, when they met Jesus, the baby, they started rejoicing. They found this baby can redeem them from all their life's troubles. The wise men from faraway countries, they came searching to have a glimpse of this baby. They traveled so far and they came to have a glimpse of this baby. Even the celestial kingdom started operating for this baby. There was a star which led the wise men to the baby. Just imagine, there was a connection between the baby and the celestial kingdom. You know why? Because He's the one who created them. The Creator of heaven and earth was born. And so the celestial, there was a celestial movement directing the wise men to the baby Jesus. Regardless of whether people accept Him or not, He has divided history. He has divided history into BC and AD. The historians acknowledge that Christ is the most significant person ever born on this earth. He is the central point of history. Not only for the history, but even to you and me, He is the central point of our lives. There is no meaning in our life without Him. When I look at myself, without Jesus, I am nothing. There's no meaning in my life without Jesus. He has brought great meaning and understanding in my life. This baby brought a permanent solution for the greatest problem that mankind faces, which is called sin, separation from God. In Matthew, an angel spoke to Joseph, saying, Mary will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. John chapter 3, verse 15 says, so that everyone, but the Son of Man has come down from heaven. He was pre-existing. He was always there. And he came down from heaven visiting us. Continues to say, God the Father so loved the world, he gave his one and only son, so that everyone who believes in him will enjoy eternal life. No one can promise this, my dear brothers and sisters. There are people who have gone through martyrdom just for the faith that they had in Jesus. Stephen was the first martyr, and when he was being thrown, he was stoned. His eyes opened and he saw the glory of God in the heavens, and he saw Jesus Christ standing at the right hand of God the Father. Where is he now? The baby who was born in Bethlehem was pre-existing. After his earthly life and resurrection, now he stands at the right hand of God. And he says to you and me, very truly I tell you, my Father will give you whatever you ask in my name. Until now, you have not asked for anything in my name. Ask and you will receive. And your joy will be complete. Joy to the world. If your joy has to be complete, you need to ask Father God in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. That is the trump card. That is the access card that will allow your voice to be heard in the throne room of God. Anyone who believes in him, my dear brothers and sisters, anyone, whosoever believes in Jesus Christ of Nazareth will not perish. They will never be damned to hell, but they will enjoy eternal life. Will you accept him today? If you have not considered Jesus as your personal Savior, may I urge you and encourage you to accept Jesus as your personal Savior in your life. You have to just say, Jesus, I need you. I need you, Jesus, in my life. Come and live within me and transform me. Give me that joy and peace and happiness that the angels spoke of. The one who was born in Bethlehem has to be born in your heart. That is the secret for the joy and happiness that the angels promised. And the songs that we sung. Let this Christmas bring inner joy and happiness through Jesus Christ. God has given you authority, my dear brothers and sisters, to accept him or to ignore him. It's up to you. I request you to give Jesus a chance in your life. I promise you, the light of the scriptures and the countless testimonies across the globe, whoever accepted Christ, their lives have been transformed. Fear driven out, diseases driven out, sickness gone, deliverance happened just by accepting Jesus who was born in Bethlehem. Not only in the light of the scriptures and through the countless testimonies across the globe, I too experienced Jesus in my life. I have a personal experience of accepting him as my Savior. He came and cleansed me from all my sins. All the past was deleted. Gave me a new life. And one thing I know, after my last breath, I live with him for eternity. God opens up the door for you and me. Today, I would encourage you to take a decision to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior and enjoy the true joy and happiness of Christmas. I pray that the true joy of Christmas will come to your heart through accepting Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Amen.